Hey guys, welcome to the YouTube video. Today it's going to be part two of making a knife to contribute to one of my favorite movies of all time ever since I was a little kid. And I've already got the blade polished out and ready to go and heat treated. So what I'm going to do now is make the handle parts. And I've got a nice piece of cherry picked out for the handle that I've already drilled through. And then I'm going to do a burn through the tang. And then I got a nice chunk of brass for the guard. And then I got a nice couple pieces for the pommel. Got a nice little brass washer for the end. And I got a nice little skull as a pommel that I'm going to put an eye patch on at the end. So let's go ahead and get to work. And don't worry, this blade doesn't have an edge, so that way I can work with it easier. There we go. Nice burn through. Like I said, it stays on there pretty tight. So when I epoxy this thing, it ain't never coming off. I'm gonna get out. There, got it off. Now let's clean this up just a little bit. That's done. Set that to the side. The next we'll make is the guard or hilt. So first thing I'm going to do is drill the holes, and then I'll file them to shape. So for that, I'll bring y'all over to my drill press. There you go. Get this bit out of here first. I was using it earlier. Oh, there it is. I need a small drill bit. Thank you. file with the shape. Got it milled out. Now we got to file with the shape. Now I got to mill it out just a little bit more. There we go. Always have a small one in my toolbox. Getting there. Yeah. Let's see. Do I have any other bigger drill bits that'll make this go a lot quicker? This will work. Found a smaller gauge drill bit. I'm going to turn the other side just a little bit more. There you go. Now I should be able to file that a little more. Oh yeah. Come on. Yeah. go. Yeah, still got to do a little bit more, but it's getting there. I always recommend when you're making a garter hilt, always have the blade right beside you so you can instantly test it to make sure it fits properly. Because you don't want to make the hole too big and you don't want to make it too small either. There we go. Nice. Nice. Now it's got to round this end up here a little bit, and we're good. Yep, there we go. All right, last. Now we gotta do is cut the shape of the guard out. With that, I'll scoot y'all over here. Sorry, this video's taking a little longer. Right there. Alrighty. Now let's cut the shape of the guard. In this video, I'm going to finish this guard up, and then I'll consider this the end of part two, and then in part three, I will have the whole thing assembled, and then I'll do the rough shaping and all that stuff. So, let's get this one done. I should have said headphones be advised, everybody. Or however they say it on YouTube. Thank you. There we go. Now I'm going to cut the corners and shave them down and shape this up. And then call it a day. Go roughly cut out. Now let's go ahead and shape this up. We go. Nice teardrop shape. Now let's use my belt sander to finish it up. I'm going to go to the next one. Here we go. Where's that? There you are. Ain't that nice? Now, last thing I'm going to do is bend the ends of this in a circle. Gives it kind of like a little flare look. And for that, I'm just going to use my little anvil over here and my drill press. I mean, not my drill press, and my little hammer. So, that out. Oh, darn, I just realized I left it inside. Give me a minute. Forgot I left it inside. Because I used it inside, too. Anyway, let's bend this guard up. So here's what it looks like before. There we go. Flared both ends up. Man, that looks nice. And the handle. Come on, get on the rack. You have to do some more shaping to the handle. Little test fit. Alrighty, this concludes part two. And then in part three, I will shape the end of this tang to accept the washer and that little skull. So hope you've enjoyed part three. Part two. So stay tuned for part three. And as always, stay sharp.